Hi, Michelle here. Today, I'll show you how to scrape any website with Web Scraper. Appify offers over 2,000 web scraping and automation tools for e-commerce portals, social media platforms, travel websites, and many other categories. These work by filling out a simple input schema, which is specific for every tool or actor, as we call them. If you, however, need more specific data or you can't find an actor for the website you want to scrape, you can use our generic web scraper. This tool operates by loading web pages in a browser, rendering dynamic content, and then using JavaScript code to fetch relevant data from the pages. But first, how does the scraper work? It starts by fetching the start URL you set in the input, loading it into the Chromium browser, executing the page function, and proceeding to find links if the link selector is filled out. This process is then repeated until the scraper runs out of start URLs. So, let's take it for a run. Head over to the link in the description and hit try for free. You'll be taken to the sign-up page where you'll be asked to create an Appify account. Don't worry, it's free and no credit card is required. Now, you land on the scraper setup page. You can set the input via our user-friendly UI or JSON. Let's go with the manual view. First, we'll need to choose the scraper's run mode. With development mode, you'll be able to see what goes on under the hood during the scrape via Chrome's DevTools. This option is great if you want to debug and fine-tune your input for the initial run. But since we're quite confident about we'll set up the actor, let's set it straight to production. Next, we'll choose the URL we want to scrape. Let's say we want data from the homepage of our open source web scraping library, Crawly. If you want to queue links that the scraper stumbles upon, you also have to set up the link selector and glob patterns. However, we're only getting text from a single page, so we'll empty the link selector and skip this section. Next is the page function. This is where you tell the scraper which data points it should focus on. It requires a bit of technological knowledge, but we'll manage. For our demo, we want to extract the installation code from Crawly, our open source web scraping library. So let's select the code snippet, hit inspect, and find the element that covers the snippet. You'll see it's part of the code block content load-bigs class. Let's test it out by going to the console and writing up a CSS selector that will grab this element and reveal the text inside. Remember to put a dot in the beginning to specify it's a class. There we go. We got the code snippet. So let's head back to our scraper's input. In the page function, we can delete the part that we don't need. So everything between the context.jQuery and the return section is where we need to tell the scraper what we wanted to grab. Let's delete everything other than the URL since we want it in our output. But this time, we're not going to use the text content property, but a jQuery call whose syntax goes like this. We're going to name a property page code block. Tell the scraper we're going to be selecting. Choose a CSS selector and that we want to find all code blocks in the page and retrieve their text content. However, when we go back to the page and search this element, we'll find there's multiple such code blocks on the page. So let's add first, open parentheses, close parentheses, before the text selector to only grab the first code block on the page. And there you go, our scraper is set up. But now that I think about it, we actually have a page for Crawly for Python, which has the same structure as the Crawly homepage in our input. So let's add that one into the start URL and see if Web Scraper can handle both of our requests. Before running your actor, we recommend saving your configuration and creating a task. This can come in handy if you want to schedule or integrate your actor with other tools in the future or if you plan to work with multiple configurations. With everything set up, just hit start to launch the actor. You can watch your results appear in the overview or you can switch to the log tab if you want to see more details about the run. Let's check our results. There we go. We have the installation codes of both Crawly and Crawly for Python extracted in a structured format. You can export these results in various formats such as JSON, CSV, or as an HTML table, and decide which fields to include or exclude. Then, you can download your dataset file. By the way, you can also run this scraper locally via API. You can find the code in Node JavaScript, Python, or CURL in the API tab of the Actor Store page. To learn more about retrieving data programmatically, check out our video on the subject. If you want to automate your workflow even further, you can schedule your actor to run at regular intervals. To do this, choose your task and hit schedule. You can then specify the frequency of how often you want to run the actor. You can even connect your scraper to other cloud services such as Google Drive, Zapier, or any other Appify actor. And that's it. After you set up web scraper for a website with a specific structure, you can scale your web scraping workflow by also crawling through links, sister pages, or search results of any platform. And remember, if you encounter any complications, please don't hesitate to report them to the actor developer through the Issues tab in the Appify console. If you like this video, please leave a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell to stay notified about future content. So long, and thanks for all the likes.